गुड मॉर्निंग शेमस्टार्स, वेलकम टू क्लास. होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. वी आर डूइंग चैप्टर नंबर 8 ऑफ सोशियोलॉजी क्लास 12 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज सोशल मूवमेंट. इन टूडेज क्लास वी विल कवर द टाइप्स ऑफ सोशल मूवमेंट. नाउ वी स्टार्ट विद द टाइप्स ऑफ सोशल मूवमेंट. दीज आर डिवाइडेड इन टू थ्री वेज टू क्लासीफाई सोशल मूवमेंट. First, reformist movement, where the reformers try to change the mindset of the people regarding a particular issue. These movements strive to change the existing social and political arrangements through gradual steps. A reform movement attempts to improve condition within an existing social system without changing the fundamental structure of the society itself. Next, we talk about the revolutionary movement. A revolutionary social movement attempt to radically transform social relations, often by capturing state power. Like the Bolshevik Revolution in Russia that deposed the Tsar to create a communist state, and the Naxalite movement in India that seeks to remove oppressive landlords and state officials can be described as revolutionary movement. Now third, we have readymade movement. It is formed to reduce action done in the past. It lies to change the thinking of the people. Next, we compare old movement and new movement. First, we talk about old movement. Most of the movements have link with political parties and they were very important. Example, freedom struggle like INC, Indian National Congress. Their main aim was that they saw the reorganization of powerful relationship. They were usually to do with economic inequality. They focus on economic inequality and they were concerned with the lower or depressed class like women and Dalits, etc. Example for this is Arya Samaj. They work for women upliftment and Dalits also. On the other hand, new movement, they do not have links to political party, may sometime oppose the practice of government. Example, worker movements. Their main aim is to address social issue, no change in power relationship. It involves economic, social, political and cultural inequality. These deals with all classes and all caste. Example like worker movement, tribal movement, all are included in new movement. Now next is the ecological movement. Any movement to do with the environment. It is a new problem and it was not there in the past. Why there is a need for ecological movement? For much of the modern period, the greater emphasis have been laid on development. Over the decades, there have been a great deal of concern about the unchecked use of natural resources and a model of development that creates new need that further demands greater exploitation of the already depleted natural resources. This model of development has also been critiqued for assuming that all section of people will be beneficiary of development. The one example of ecological movement was the Chipko movement. The Chipko movement in the Himalayan foothills is a good example of this kind of interest and ideology. According to Ramchandra Goha in his book Unquiet Woods, villagers rallied together to save the oak forest near their villages. When government forest contractors came to cut down the trees, villagers, including large number of women, stepped forward to hug the trees to prevent their being felled. At stake was the question of villagers' subsistence. All of them relied on the forest to get firewood, fodder and other daily necessity. This conflict placed the livelihood needs of poor villagers against the government's desire to generate revenue from selling timber. In addition, the Chipko movement also expressed the resentment of hill villagers against a distant government headquartered in the plains that seem indifferent and hostile to their concern. So concerns about economy, ecology and political representation underlay the Chipko movement. Chipko movement is a movement which was not only economic aspect, it affected all aspect. Economically, when contractor from cities came to cut down the trees, the women and children went and hugged the trees. Reason being, they were dependent on the forest for their livelihood. On the other hand, politically, villagers were unhappy that politicians sitting in the cities were dictating terms, and they knew politicians were not concerned about their livelihood. It became popular. Mass media was important in spreading the news, and people started their own movements in their own states. Now we talk about the class-based movement. First we talk peasant movement. In the period of pre-colonial, there were movements, but they were not localized, so we did not know about them, as peasants were too scared to form their own movements. They were poor and could not mobilize people. Then during colonial rule in 19th century, some revolts did become quite popular. Like one of them was Bengal revolt. Indigo plantation by Gandhi during 1917 to 1920. When he came back from South Africa, he traveled all across India helping people. There were two important movements, Champaran and Bardoli. Bardoli Satyagraha, that was in 1928, Surat district, a non-tax campaign as part of nationwide non-cooperative movement, a campaign of refusal to pay land revenue, and second was the Champaran Satyagraha, year 1917 to 18, directed against indigo plantation. In the 1920s, protest movements against that forest policies of the British government and local rulers arose in certain areas. Between 1920 and 1940, peasant organizations arose. The first organization to be founded was the Bihar Provincial Kisan Sabha, 1929, and in 1936 the All India Kisan Sabha. The peasants organized by the sabhas demanded freedom from economic exploitation for peasants, workers and all other exploited classes. At the time of independence, we had the two most classical case of peasant movement, that were the Tibhaga movement and the Telangana movement. This we will discuss in our next session. Thank you, Shamstars. That's all for today. You can drop your queries on the Google Classroom. Take care.